Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and also welcome back to Color and Gab. But before we actually get started with the Color and Gab, I wanted to go ahead and share with you the color alongs that's going to be happening in April and into May. Okay, so we just finished up with Laura's color along, which ended over this past weekend. But Shalene's is going to be starting on April 8th. And that will be going through April 15th. So that's just going to be starting in just a few short days. So on YouTube, she is Shalene Toland. And on Facebook, you can join her coloring group at Color with Shalene and Friends. So with hers, you can do any Bennett Klein or any Sherry Baldy. Okay, so next is Jessica's color along. And Jessica on YouTube is Jessica Robertson. You can also join her Facebook group at Jessica's Coloring Corner. Hers is going to be starting from April 15th through April 23rd. And with hers, you can do any Johanna Basford, any Hannah Carlson, and any Bennett Klein. Okay, so mine is going to be starting on April 21st and will go through the April 28th. So mine and Jessica's is going to be overlapping just a little bit. On YouTube, of course, I am Sweet Nightingale 1973. On Facebook, you can find my Facebook group at Color with Sharon and Friends, or you can find my Facebook page at Color with Sharon. You can join the group or you can go ahead and follow the page. I do quite a bit of activity on both of them, so it just depends on what avenue you want to do that, or you can do both. That's perfectly fine. And with mine, you can do any Johanna Basford, any Hannah Lynn, any of the Harry Potter books that's got the magical creatures, the magical artifacts, places and characters, and then the original Harry Potter book. Or you can do any of the mandala books by Jim Gogarty. There's two of them that I am aware of. And those are pretty inexpensive on Amazon. When we get closer to the time, I will show you the books again. All right. So then, last but certainly not least, Grace is also doing a color along. And if you guys haven't seen her channel, you guys need to go over there and subscribe to her. She is Grace Fonseca on YouTube, F-O-N-S-E-C-A. And then she's also got a Facebook group called Grace's Coloring Book Corner. And hers is going to be starting on April 28th through May 7th. So when mine is finishing up, hers is going to be starting. Okay, and with hers, you can do any of the Daria Song books, any books by Daria Song, which is Time Garden, Time Chamber, and Night Voyage. You can also do in the Buffy the Vampire Slayer book, which I don't have. I guess I should have figured that there was one out there, so I'm going to have to look into getting that one, I think. You can also do any Hannah Carlson books. That's Daydreams, Summer Nights. Yeah, Summer Nights, and then now with the new one, Magical Dawn, and she's probably got some others that are in her native tongue. And also with a lot of these, too, you can do the international versions if you like. You can also do any Jade Summer book. I'm not familiar with a lot of her work, but I have heard of her, so I'll have to look at some of her books, too. So for Grace's, any Daria Song, any Hannah Carlson, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, or any of the Jade Summer books. All right, so that's it for the color alongs that are going to be happening. Okay, so for the color and gab, what I thought we would do is go back to our Emoji Crazy book. I did a color and gab with this book, but I did not finish up the picture that I started, so I thought we would go ahead and work on that with all the color alongs happening. I just haven't had the chance to work on that picture that I started. So there's still quite a bit left of it to do, so we're going to go ahead and do that. And let me just refresh your guys' memory on what we have done. Okay. So this is what we started. If you guys can see that, this is what we started on the, not the previous color and gab, but the one before. And so, as you can see, we are just right where we left off. And I was using the Derwent Color Soft Pencils on this. So what I thought we would do is I thought we'd work on this one just a little bit more. I would say I'm about halfway done with it, but there's still the stars to do. There's still these stripes over here to do, plus the hat and stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and get set up, and then I will be right back. All right, guys, so here we are. Now, what I thought we would do is go ahead and work on this little hat thing right here that's just kind of above the emoji's face right there. And so I'm going to go ahead and do my little disclaimer like I usually do in these, in case any new people wander onto this channel. I've gotten quite a few subscribers over the last couple of weeks, so for their benefit, and also for any new people that are going to wander on to this channel. I'm coloring with a visual impairment, so that means I have to get really close to my page that I'm working on, unfortunately. I try to do my best to keep the back of my head out of the way as much as I can, but it's just kind of the nature of the beast that I deal with, and so sometimes you're going to see my big head in the way. I try to edit out like the biggest portions of that, but I can't edit all of it out. So I do apologize for that. I wish that I could avoid that, but I cannot, unfortunately, or I can't avoid it totally. So we will just make the most of it, and we'll make the most of it. All right. So what we're going to go ahead and do is start out with this blood orange color. And again, I'm using the Derwent Color Soft to finish up this picture, because that's what we started with. And then I'm going to take this deep red and do some blending and do some darker areas with that and blend it and shade it, of course, as best I can. And I think I might even grab another lighter orange, but we're going to just see how this works. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on this and we'll get started. All right, so let's go ahead and get this show on the road here. So I'm going to just go ahead and take this orange and I'm going to just go lightly over this area. I'm gonna try to find a lighter orange and try to get where I can maybe blend three colors together, which would be nice. And it's really dreary here today. I think I'm gonna have to make a little bit of contrast with this red, because as you can see, this is pretty close. I think this is one of the oranges that I used, or the yellow and orange that I used on the actual face. So I'm gonna outline it with, just gonna do a little bit of outlining with this red right there. And then maybe just take this red up into this area. Okay. And same thing, oops, over here on this side. Okay. Let's take it up a little bit. I don't know how good this is gonna look, but we're experimenting, we're playing, and that's what we're gonna do. All right. So we're gonna take this orange again, and I'm just gonna go lightly over all of this. So, what's everybody been up to this week? Me, I've been up to about 5 foot. Oh, yeah, that's an old joke. But, this week has been pretty quiet, actually. Those of you that have been watching my Hobonichi flip through, we'll probably know that I had my choral group's concerts over the last weekend, but that is pretty much all done, officially done. There's a couple more little things that they're going to be doing, which I'm not going to be able to attend, but all of the big concerts and stuff are done. I'm going to take this red and just kind of go over here onto the edge. Hopefully you guys can see that. But yeah, all the big stuff is done, so I will have a nice long break for the summer, which is good. That will be very, very nice. And I'm not pressing very hard on this, but I kind of pressed a little bit right there, but to me this looks a little bit more like a pink rather than a red. But I don't want to put too much of a heavy layer on this because I do want to
I do want it to blend with this orange. So anyway, like I said, this week has been pretty quiet. Not too much has been happening. We do have something going on Thursday night, but other than that, like, it's been pretty quiet.
Okay, then I'm going to come back over here on this side.
And I know when I get over here on the right-hand side, like, my head really gets in the way, and I'm trying not to let that happen as much. But when I have my head down, I can't really look into my viewfinder and see where it's positioned. So I do apologize if my head is in the way. Like I always say in the videos, we will try to make do the best we can and make the most of our circumstances. That's all you can do, you know, in life. You know, you deal with what you got to deal with, and you make adaptations. You know what they say in the Wild Kingdom, survival of the fittest and all that. And if you can't adapt to your surroundings, then you are going to die. Obviously in the Animal Kingdom world, you know, it's you know, you're either hunted, you're either the hunted or you're the hunter. You know, in the human world, I mean, you know, obviously you can die physically, but there's more than one way to die. You can kind of die inside from emotional emptiness, I guess, call it that. Oh boy, now we're getting a little philosophical here, guys. Oh, goodness me. I don't know where that came from, but... But basically, you make the most of your circumstances as best you can, and you just deal. You have to learn how to deal. So yesterday was local elections, local and county stuff to vote on. So we went to vote yesterday. I'm going to try to make this a little bit darker up here. I'm going to press a little bit harder. I did a real light layer of that red, but what I'm going to try to do is darken some of this up to give it a little bit more variety. These pencils are nice. I really, really like these pencils. They don't blend as well as, say, the Faber-Castell Polychromos or the Luminance. I mean, the Luminance ones really blend nicely. And these do very well. I really enjoy these pencils, and you get a really nice color selection.
I do have the full set of these, which is, I believe, 72. But you can get these in smaller sets, and they do have them open stock, which is nice. Okay. I hope you guys can see that.
But they do have them in smaller sets and open stock, which is nice. I got these things like last summer. I think I got them in July or August or something, about the same time that I got my ink tents, and I really, really, really love my ink tents. Now, on this paper, it is so thin that I would not use any kind of watercolor on it, just because it is very, very thin, and I would probably destroy it in the process. All right, so I'm going to do the same thing over here with this red on this one. I probably could have picked up a lighter color, another lighter and darker one to give it a little bit more, but I did not. Let's see. I think if I just go lighter right in through here. And then I'm gonna make this a little bit darker. I'm gonna press a little bit harder. Now, one thing is you can definitely shade with like two or three colors, but you can even get variation of colors just by pressing down a little bit more on your pencils. It's not always the best way to go because if you press too hard, you will burnish your color into your paper when you may not want to. So it's kind of a fine line to figure out. What is best or not. Okay, so I'm gonna take this orange and I'm gonna just blend it a little bit. Okay, and then whoops. Slap down that color. Why don't I? I've seen a lot of people do the acrylic backgrounds on their pictures lately. I think Dee Dee Willingham has been doing that, and I've seen another person do that several months back in Anamorphia. And it looks really nice. Like I got a set of Liquitex Basics paint, and you've seen me haul that on one of my videos last, I think it was last summer or fall or something like that. And so it was either 48 tubes or 60 tubes, and they're real small. I guess you could call it sample size, but it's plenty to actually get your, you know, to actually do a few backgrounds. And also, like, if you do art journaling and stuff, it's, to me, I think they're perfect sizes for that. Now they do make bigger tubes of that, I know. And also, for a lot of people, stuff they've been using stuff like Apple Barrel, I think, and what was that one, Americana, I think, paint, which is craft paint. Liquitex Basics, I think, is a little thicker than that. It's not quite as liquidy. I don't have any Apple Barrel or anything, so I can't really compare it. But Liquitex Basics goes down really, really nicely. And especially like if you're doing your art journal and if you gesso your pages and stuff, it will go down, it'll go down really nice. It'll go down very, very nicely. Oops, oh boy. Ay, ay, ay. And there goes my little out of the line dealy. But I got my little Faber-Castell eraser here, and it's a tiny, tiny place. So I should be able to get that up pretty well. And brush that off.
Somebody was saying, when I did a haul video of this eraser, somebody was saying that it reminded them of those old typewriter erasers that you know, that go way, way, way back. And I have to agree with that. I remember my aunt had one of those, and I thought it was the coolest thing. And I always wanted to play with it. I remember that. I think I liked the little brush. And I couldn't fathom that it was actually an eraser because it didn't feel like an eraser because it was in a pencil. It was a pencil.
All right, so I'm gonna put back my color that I took off in the erasing part. All right. I hope you guys can see that.
But yeah, like I said, I had seen people do this acrylic paint, but I've not done that in any of my books. I'm kind of afraid to because I am so afraid of actually getting it right on my image. And so I would be totally kicking myself and cussing myself out if I did that. So
I'm just gonna have to get brave and actually just do it one day. Because really, and this is easier said than done, but you really shouldn't be afraid of your supplies. You know, it's just supplies and it's just the book, and you know, playing with it is how you learn with it. So I just need to suck it up and just do it. All right, so there is our little hat for our little emoji guy, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and pick some colors, and we're gonna do these next empty stripes right here. All right, so for the stripes, now we did these in, we did those colors on these stripes here, but I think these colors here, now this is, I'm gonna take blue for the lighter color. Oops, there's blue. And then I believe this one here is bottle blue. We're gonna use that for the darker color, and we're gonna put the darker colors and then the lighter colors toward the middle like we did with these other stripes. So I think, I'm hoping that this will look really nice together. We will see. Okay, so just trying to get where I can do this where you guys can see without my head being in the way too terribly much.
Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and cover these little stripes with the blue. And I'm gonna do like a real light layer like I did with the others. So this here is just a real light blue, it looks like. This blue one.
Okay. Maybe if I do it like this.
I'm just trying to get it so my head is not in the way for you guys too much. I try to be mindful of that, I really do. So, as you guys know, or maybe you don't if you're new here and didn't participate, but we just had a giveaway. That went on for a little bit over a week, and I announced the winners of it yesterday. So thank you to everybody who entered and participated. And I really enjoyed doing this giveaway, and the books are going to be going out in the mail. I'm hoping I can get a couple of them out tomorrow. I have to get some packing materials, and I'll probably get my husband to just take him to the post office on his way into work. But I am looking to get those books out in the mail for everybody this week, everybody that won. So congratulations to our winners. And thank you to everybody who participated. And thank you also. Thank you also to everyone for your support and your love and all your lovely, lovely comments on my videos and saying how much you enjoy watching me. I can't tell you what that means and how greatly I appreciate that. I am just really staggered and blown away just over the support that I've received since starting to do all this. And it's funny because this channel, like, I don't say that I devote it to one specific thing. Like, I've had a lot of journal videos on here. Here lately it's been a lot of coloring stuff, which is fine. I love doing the coloring stuff. But yeah, I've had a lot of journaling stuff on there too. And of course, hauls. I do a lot of haul videos, I know that. But what seems to make it really nice is, you know, the funny thing is that it seems like my, looking back on like the haul videos versus like all the other stuff, like my hauls really get a lot of people watching, it seems like. A lot of people love haul videos, it looks like, and me included. I mean, I enjoy watching those kinds of videos because I like seeing what people got, and I like I like just, you know, seeing what people are enjoying, and it gives me ideas of, you know, things I might need or things I might want to get. So, yeah, it's a fun thing to do, but in a way it's kind of dangerous because YouTube is so good for enabling your addictions, your likes, you know, but it's fun, you know. I really enjoy watching those kinds of videos.
All right, so how does that look, you guys? What do you think?
I think that looks pretty good against the oranges and stuff. Okay, so let's go ahead on to the next stripe. And again, just trying to make sure that I have everything in frame. I zoomed in here pretty close. Where I'm at right now is I'm at my desk in my living room rather than on my kitchen table. This book is kind of small, so I thought I would just go ahead and do my simpler setup in here rather than drag my big, big tripod out and set it up in the kitchen. This makes it a little easier. But then I have to make sure I have plenty of light in here, and it's really dreary in here right now. I think I've got like every light on in this living room. Yep. I think what I want to try to get, guys, next time I go shopping, which will probably be a while, I'm kind of in coloring book jail and I'm kind of in Amazon jail right now, but I have to wait for a little bit. But what I'm going to try to get is I'm going to try to look for a, and I really don't know what the best name for it is, but when I had one when I was in school, we called it a slant board, and it was basically two pieces of wood, and one of them tilts up at varying angles. It tilts up at varying degrees. And so
instead of like having the book laying down like this, it would be tilted up kind of like this. And so it's not quite so hard on my neck, you know, bending way over. I'd still have to bend over, but just not as much, or not to that degree, I guess, that I'm bending over now. Now, when I got mine, as I said, I have a visual impairment, so I was able to get certain things. And I had a vision teacher that came out to see me about 2 to 3 times a week. And so she was able to get me these different aids and stuff. And the slant board was one of them. And I felt like I came from a real tiny town, like really teeny tiny town. And so everybody knew that I was different, I guess. And it was kind of a,
you know, when you're a kid and you're trying to fit in, you feel really self-conscious because you want to fit in, and any kind of differences, like, people will make fun of. And, believe me, I saw a lot of that growing up. And, so anyway, I felt really just, I felt like I stuck out like a sore thumb with that thing. But what I had to look at, and I was a little older and wiser, by the time I came to this conclusion, was, you know, if it helps and if it makes my life easier, you know, I'm all for it. And let me tell you what, I loved that slant board. And I wish I still had it, because even though it was clunky and bulky, I mean, it was such a help. And then also when I was in school, along with the slant board, I had a lamp with a gooseneck lamp, and it had the fluorescent bulbs in it. And that was back in the day when those fluorescent bulbs were very, very, very expensive. And and you didn't really see them a lot. But with that lamp, I had the fluorescent bulbs, and between that and the slant board, boy, I love that. Because I have a really, really hard time seeing, like if I'm bending over and there's a shadow on my page. I have a really hard time with that. So the fluorescent light really helped out with all that. It took away the shadows. And then with the slant board, and I'm to get real close for a minute, you guys, just give me a sec. So with the slant board,
I hope you guys can see that.
With the slant board and the light, it was just so helpful. And I really wish I had that set up now because I could really use it in certain circumstances, let me tell you that. But we make do. Now those fluorescent bulbs are, they're being replaced by the LED lights. So a lot of what you see now are the LED or LCD lights, something like that. And then the collagen bulbs, I think the regular collagen bulbs, you don't really see. Not too many people are using those as much anymore. I mean, some do and they're still around. But it seems like there's ones that that are better for saving power and better energy savers and stuff. It kind of saves on your electricity bill. So, like I said, I have not had anything to haul for you guys lately because I've not, I was very blessed to get what I was able to get in March, but that was kind of a rarity, really, because I had a little bit of extra money from some work that I had done, which that's not going to be happening for quite a while yet again. So
I will obviously make more haul videos, but it's just not going to be to the degree that I did for in March. But I do plan, next time when I go shopping, I do plan to get, I do have some more books that I'm planning to get.
There's a few on my wish list that I've been wanting to get. And I've also been thinking about picking up some NeoColor 2s. I've seen a lot of those lately, or I've seen those on quite a few videos. Jessica had it on one of her videos, Jessica Robertson. And, I had never picked them up before. I had my ink tents, and I love my ink tents. And, those can never be replaced, but I've been hearing a lot of really great things about, NeoColor 2s. And, of course, Dee Dee Willingham, if you watch her, boy, she's got everything. I mean, she has got everything. So, I guess if you want good information on products and what she considers good, I don't think you would go wrong with watching her stuff. Now, I've not visited her channel lately, and with all this privacy stuff going on and the hacking and stuff, I don't know who's doing what, honestly. I don't know who has what out there anymore. I don't know who's going to continue to do what.
Being as busy as I have been, I've not been watching a whole lot of videos lately.
I pretty much just saw like all the privacy stuff happening. And I did my own. If you guys looked at my channel, I'd put up one too. I was not affected, thank goodness. But I feel bad for the ones that have been. And I hope
you guys can get it, you know, I hope they can get it straightened out. Because that is no fun to feel like you have been violated or to have been violated. And I'm looking for my sharpener. Here we go. Sharpen up a couple of these pencils. All right. So yeah, it's no fun to feel like your privacy has been invaded, and it's certainly no fun to actually have your privacy being invaded. That's a scary feeling, and like I said in my video, you can really get into a dangerous situation if you are not careful. Okay.
All right. Okay, so I'm going to take this darker color and do a little bit
more on these stripes right here. Ugh. I can get where you guys can see this. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to lift this up just a little bit.
Ooh, I got out of my line a little bit, went into my orange. Ugh. Crap. Crap, 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 crap. Ooh. I will have to try to fix that a little bit later. Okay, so back with the regular blue, we're going to do a little bit of blending on this one. I've also got my Derwent blender. I don't have my Prismacolor one handy right at the moment, but I have my Derwent one, and I could blend with that a little bit should I need to. Okay. Here. So, has anybody got any new coloring books, interesting coloring books lately? I have not. The last ones I got was the ones that I showed you, and I think that was the Clara Markova one, the Magical Delights. And the ones that I had for the giveaway and the ones that I reviewed. So that is where I am sitting right now. All right.
I guess that, oh my gosh, and my page came out of the book. Well, okay. So these pages, like if you don't realize it, these will come out of this book very easily. Now, the way it's bound is it's glue bound, so these will come out if you don't watch it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to close up this book. And now that this page has come out, oh goodness, now that this page has come out, I think I'm going to try to do a little bit of a different setup. So just give me a sec and I'll be right back. All right guys, so we're going to go ahead and take this light sand color. And what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to color in all of the stars. Now, as you see, this picture came right out of the book because it is a glue binding and they'll come out. So you can tear these out pretty easily if you want to. And I'm not fussed about it because this is actually going to go right into my journal. So that's going to be put in there as soon as I'm done with it. So anyway, let's go ahead and color in all of these stars. Okay, so I'm hoping that I'm going to be able to get this in frame so that you guys can see it.
Okay, so and this is a pretty light yellow color, this light sand. And what I think I'm going to do is do some of these stripes and purples because I think that would look pretty nice. So anyway, I was just asking if you guys had any interesting coloring books lately. And you know, I was going to ask everybody, what else do you like to do besides color? I'm sure that a lot of you have other hobbies as well. I don't know if you guys knew this or not, but I like to crochet. I did learn how to knit a few years ago, but I am a much better crocheter than I am a knitter. I have been crocheting since about 2001. I tried to learn back in the 90s when I was still in high school. My stepmother tried to teach me, but I could not get it. Like, I could not pick it up. Like, I had a heck of a hard time. And even doing a chain stitch, like, it took me hours to do a chain of 40, you know. And now, like, I can just whip it out like crazy. But So what happened was, like, I quit, like, I put it aside because I just could not get it. I was getting so frustrated. And then I went off to college. I went off to college, and then I didn't have time to really pursue it much anymore. But I always vowed that I would pick it back up and I was going to learn it or die trying, you know, because once I get a bee in my bonnet, I can get pretty determined. And you can ask my husband on that one. But so I picked it up back up in about in 2001, and it just seemed to click. Like I was able to get it, the hang of it. And what I like to make mostly is blankets. You know, I like to make these afghans. I've made stuff like scarves and pot holders and coasters and bookmarks, and I even made like little snowflakes out of the crochet thread. But those really aren't my favorite to do. I have a hard time with the little bitty thread. I prefer using like a worsted weight yarn. Or medium weight, like if you're going to make a sweater or something like that. And then I had also wanted to learn how to knit too. Now that one was a challenge. That one was a chore. I did manage to learn how to do it, but I feel more confident with crocheting. I'm a better crocheter than I am a knitter. And like when you make a mistake with crocheting, it's pretty easy to fix. Like, you know, it's pretty easy to rip out and fix, but with knitting, it's a bit more of a challenge. And there's times where I have to go and recover in a dark room after that. because when you make a mistake with knitting, you got to take it off the needle, and you got to rip it back, and then you got to make sure that you're, when you put it back on the needle, you got to make sure your loops are in the right direction. And oh goodness me, it is a challenge sometimes. Mostly what I knit though is scarves. I don't do a whole lot of big projects with knitting. I do a lot of scarves. If anybody would like to see me crochet on a video, just let me know. I can do that. I've never done an actual crochet video, but I know a lot of you that are here are for the coloring, which is fine. But you know, if there's something else that you want me to do, like the crocheting or whatever, I can do that. Cause I got a blanket that I've been working on for quite a long time. Kind of my walk of shame. Like I haven't crocheted in a while. And now that the weather's gonna start to get nicer and warmer, I don't know how much of it I will be doing. I tend to not do it too much in the summertime, just because the yarn gets really, really, really heavy, and it can get like if you're doing a big project, it can get really hot when it's sitting on your lap. So I don't do a whole lot of that during the summer. Okay. Just trying to make sure that I have everything in the frame so you guys can see. These stars are kind of little. As you guys know, because of the visual impairment, I tend to like to do a lot of the bigger spaces on camera, but I will try to, I'm going to do these stars, or some of them anyway. I like to crochet. I like to knit, even though I enjoy crocheting more. When I get in the mood, I like to scrapbook. I have quite a lot of scrapbooking supplies. I've got a few things to do, some art journaling. Which I'm probably going to be doing a bit of over the summer. I'll probably just take my audiobook player into the kitchen on the table and listen to my audiobook while I, you know, work on some journal pages. And hopefully keep it out of the, you know, keep everything out of harm's way from the paint and stuff. But I have a pretty big workspace in there when I need that. Okay. like to cook a lot more than I do now. Like, I don't like to cook as much anymore. Now it's just kind of like, meh. But I used to enjoy that a lot more than I do now. I don't enjoy it as much anymore. And of course, you guys know that I like to sing. You guys have heard me sing on video, I think one time. One time you did. And if you guys want to hear anything like that again, let me know. Not too much to say while I'm working on these stars right now. What are you guys currently reading? I am reading, it's called The Second Opinion, and it's by Michael Palmer, I think is the author. Michael Palmer, and it's, the book has been around a few years. I have read it before, but sometimes I like to go back and revisit stuff that I've read before, especially like if it's been a really long time, because there's some things that I forget, and there's some elements to the story that I kind of forgot, so I decided to go ahead and read it again. So that is what I am doing. I have also been listening to my old-time radio shows. I like stuff like, now this is stuff that we're talking about like before TV even came into existence. Like, you know, we're talking stuff like Jack Benny, The Shadow. There was a show called Suspense. Dragnet. Now Dragnet was on the radio before it was on TV. There was one called Escape that I like. And Inner Sanctum, which was kind of a, they got some sci-fi stuff on there, but it's kind of a thriller, kind of a spooky thriller show. Lights Out is very spooky and kind of scary. Although, like if you listen to that and if you think about what we have now, it is very tame. Like Lights Out is very tame compared to, compared to what we are exposed to now. But still, there's some of those shows that still have the ability to creep me out. Even though I have listened to them for a very long time. Okay, so all the stars on that side is done. We'll keep going for a little bit more. I'm going to try to get like all the rest of these stars colored in. I'll finish up the stripes probably off camera and then the rest of this hat, because we got a little bit more of this hat to do right there. Okay. So I think this little emoji guy is going to come out really cute. I think he's going to come out really cute looking. Get a little bit more. Ooh, and I got out of my line right there. I'm going to have to fix that, I think. Okay. All right. Try to get where you guys can see this. Again, sometimes I wonder how much of this you guys can actually see. I mean, I find out when I edit the footage, but I don't always know when I'm doing this. You know, since I'm looking down this way and can't see through my screen. Okay. Have you guys seen any good movies lately? I have not watched a movie in a while. I've not gone to the movies since, I think the last time I went to the movies was in October of the year when the movie Gravity came out, and that was one with Sandra Bullock in it. Sandra Bullock and George Clooney. That was where they were stranded in space after a meteor shower destroyed their ship. But we went to the movies to see that when it came out. But other than that, like, I have not gone to the movie theater. It's expensive to go anymore. Like, you know, my husband and I were talking over the weekend, and with my concerts and stuff, now what we do is we do not eat too much, you know, before we do our concerts and stuff, because, you know, singing on a full stomach isn't really good for you, and it's actually hard for some people to do that. So, you know, by the time we're done, like, we're all starving. So we usually go out to dinner after our concerts are over. So we went out like 3 times over the weekend, and we were just, you know, my husband and I were just talking about how expensive it is to do anything. Like, you know, going out to dinner is expensive. Going to the movies now is expensive. I mean, it depends on the time of the day you're going to go to the movie, but still, you know, it can get expensive, especially if you're taking a few people. So, I don't know. You know, people, I don't think you're doing as much out anyway. Sorry for my middle finger there, guys. I don't think people are doing very much out. Not like they used to. You know, way back when I was younger, like, we do quite a lot. But things are expensive anymore. And of course, it's expensive to travel too. I think our last big trip was we went to Australia a few years back, and that was Lions Club related, really, which was really the only reason we went. And then we went to Puerto Rico long time ago. But, like, you know, we don't go to Disney World. You know, we don't do the whole we don't do the whole timeshare like some people do. There's some times where we don't even take any kind of trip at all. We used to go to, in Michigan, there is a, it's called the Greenfield Village and the Henry Ford Museum, which we used to go to that a lot, like years and years and years ago. We used to go to that a lot. We even had a membership for that, but we don't do that anymore either. So most of the time, you know, like, unless it's like Lions Club related or something, like, we just stay home, and, you know, we put a lot of our money toward, like, toward the pen show, like when we go to the pen show every year, you know, so we put a lot of our money toward, like, fountain pens and stuff like that, you know, something that you're going to have to show for years to come. So we do that a lot. We save up for the pen show every year, and we do quite a bit of damage there. If you watched my Chicago pen show haul from 2016, you will know what kind of damage I did. And but because both my husband and I like fountain pens, you know, both of us, we end up expanding our collection very vastly. Okay.
I hope you guys can see this. I really do.
I'm gonna have to sharpen my pencil. Get my sharpener out here. So, all right, a little bit more. There we go. All right.
Whoops. Oops, I will have to fix that. This color is so light, though, that, you know, once I put some other stuff down, that mistake is going to not show. And I can always take my eraser and get rid of that. I just colored a little bit right there between the stars. So do you guys like these longer coloring gabs? Like, do you like them about an hour, a little bit over an hour? Or do you like them to be anywhere from, say, 30 to 45 minutes? So tell me what you guys like. Do you like the longer ones, or more short ones? This, I don't know how much you're going to be able to see. I'm having to get in really close on some of these because it's so tiny up here. Now, I'm not going to be able to finish this picture on camera because I still got quite a bit more to do with the stripes and stuff, but when I get it done, I will show it to you guys. And I'll put the work in progress on Instagram and on my Facebook group. Come over and join my Facebook group. And then, of course, once I get it done, it's going to go into my journal, and then I will show you guys the finished one. I'm not going to be able to do too much shading on these stars. This is where I want to get some stickles and put some glitter on it, but I do have a little bit of glitter glue, and I do have some other glitter that I can use in a pinch. Just go over these a little bit. I think that's going to do it for the stars for the most part. All right, guys, I think that's going to do it for the stars for the most part. There's what it looks like. Here is what it looks like so far. Still got this part of the hat to do, and then I have these other stripes to fill in, which I'm going to have to do off camera. But I think right now I'm going to go ahead and say goodbye, and because we've been at it for a little bit, and we can always do another picture in the next coloring gab. And as I said, I will put this work in progress on Instagram and on my Facebook group so you guys can see it. Plus, when the finished picture is done, I will put that picture up on the Facebook group and on Instagram so you guys can see it. So anyway, you guys have a great day. And if you haven't done so already, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. And better yet, while you're at it, hit that bell. You'll be notified when I upload new material.
You guys have a great day. Leave a comment and hit the like button, of course. You guys have a great day, and we'll talk to you all later. All right, bye, guys.